Yeah, I painted, I used watercolor to recreate one of my artist's paintings. I redrew what he did, and then I started to paint over it with watercolor. My artist usually uses acrylic paint, so, but I use watercolor. And I didn't have the right kind of paper for the watercolor paint, so I had to use printer paper, which worked okay. It just made it a little bit wrinkly, but that's okay.
You can do the top arrow, there you go.
Okay.
Oh, the top arrow on the left of your EP.
Oh, yeah.
And then you should be able to find the next one.
And then what?
And then scroll down, does the next one show up?
I began my project by, at first I didn't have any art supplies at my dorm, and we didn't have any friends or whatever. So I had to go to Walmart and get some. I did get it, but I left it in my friend's car, and then he got it mixed up with trash, so it got thrown out. But it was around Thanksgiving break, so, and I did have artwork at my, I did have like the art supplies at my house, so I just brought that back with me. But I did forget the paper, so I had to use the paper. Okay, yeah. And then I just... Okay. I thought it was a bad idea using watercolor paint because it wouldn't keep going over the lines, and it made it look really sloppy, like in this picture right here. So yeah, I had to fix it, and I'm really, and the paper kept getting wrinkly. Okay, so I kind of fixed it a little bit because I traced the lines with a black pen so you couldn't really tell. It made it a little neater. Okay, I learned that it's better to use acrylic paint than watercolor. And you can't even tell that it's wrinkly anymore because I put my psychology book over it to make it look black over there.
Nice.
Did you bring it?
Like, yeah, I did.
Okay.
You should show us.
Yeah.
Okay, I will. But overall, it was pretty good. I thought it was cool. I thought it was pretty cool.